God that knows me knows I love to do what God tells me to do. Because once upon a time, I didn't really do it right away. And boy, did he look at me like, you know, not what. My kids can tell you, I was in a bad shape. Because God had called me, y'all might not know this, and I don't know why I'm calling you now, maybe because of the situation with the mouth and all that kind of stuff. But for 33 years, I ran away from my home. For 33 years, I ran. And then one day, God got tired of me running.
That's right.
He got tired of me running.
He caught up with you.
He knew where I was all the time.
That's right.
He didn't have to catch up with me.
That's right.
He just knew where I was. Yeah. And he put a whipping on me. And I was flat on my back for it seemed like a total of about 3 months. I cannot move. Y'all don't know about this, but my kids know about it. I lay on the sofa.
Testify.
And I just couldn't move. But I promised God, and I said, Lord, if you get me up from here, I will do what you want me to do.
All right, all right.
I say, if I have to go by myself, I will do it. Whatever you want me to say, I will say it. Even if it's a church with nobody in it but one person, I say, I will go. God got me up. I called Pastor Davis. When I got to see him, he said, come to his office. And that was when he was around the corner someplace, not like where he is now, but it was downstairs, but in that little corner. You all know who I'm talking about, near where the baptism pool used to be. And he said, why are you here? He said, you knew why I was there, but he wanted me to just tell him. And when I told him, he said, why did it take you so long? He told me because I was afraid. But he said, you don't have to be afraid. When God calls you, he equips you. Yeah. And it doesn't matter whether people want to receive it or not. He said, what God gives you.
That's right.
And that's all
to tell you.
Amen. Many prophets in the Bible, God called them. They did what God wanted them to do. People ignored their word.
That's right.
And they got punished for it.
Yeah.
People walked away from Jesus. greater than any force on this earth or any place else.
Glory.
There is no power nowhere that is greater than Jesus. Jesus. And they told them that They didn't stop using the name of Jesus. And many people today, you go places and they don't want to hear anything about Jesus. You can say all the pop songs you want to say. You can do all the curse words you want to do. And they don't care. But you say Jesus one time and somebody will shut you up.
Yes, that preacher.
Don't let it stop you from using the name of Jesus.
Amen.
If it wasn't power in the name, they wouldn't care if you use it.
Really?
You say these S words that you hear the president said on the news the other day. Mm-hmm. You know, people talk about it. Why? Because he's the president. But yeah. If he wasn't the president, nobody would say anything about it.
President.
Amen. You go out there and you say all your bad words that you want to say. Nobody's going to worry you about it.
That's right.
But the minute you use the name Jesus, somebody's got a problem with
Amen.
That.
That's
now,
right.
I know for myself, and I hope you know for yourself too,
reach out, Kyle.
That any time you call on the name Jesus,
glory.
Things begin to happen.
Yes, it does.
Like the thank you, Lord, I can play today, but I just played it till I felt like God.